Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I am going to explain you two very interesting terminologies. Those are transmission delay and propagation delay. See, this transmission delay and propagation delay that you will be frequently using in problem solving of computer network. So first of all, you should understand what is the meaning of it. And to explain that, I'll explain you both of these terminologies along with practical examples. So that will resolve your understanding regarding how to solve those terminologies. So let us try to understand first, what is transmission delay? See, transmission delay is amount of delay for transmitter to transmit frames on the media. Like you see, here we are having transmitter, and this transmitter is connected with receiver via this media, right? So how much time that transmitter will take to place data on the media, that is defined by transmission delay, right? So to understand that, you see, if I say size of the frame or packet, that is L, and if bandwidth of the medium, that is B, then by simply L by B, we can calculate transmission delay. You see how? For example, L is there in terms of bits per frame, right? So one by one, bits are getting placed on the media, and bandwidth of the media, if I say that is B, then with respect to that bandwidth only, this transmitter can place those data on the media, right? So L is bits divided by bandwidth is there in terms of bits per second, right? Then this bits will get cancelled and you will be having transmission delay as per L by B. So by high school mathematics only we can calculate this, right? Like as if size of frame, that is L, and as if bandwidth of the medium, that is B, then simply by L by B, we can find transmission delay. What is that? It is amount of time required for transmitter to place given frame on the media, right? Now to understand that, let me explain you one example. Like you see, if size of packet, that is given as per 1 KB. So here, size of packet L, that is given 1 KB. And here, bandwidth of the medium, that is given 1000 BPS. So bandwidth, that is given 1000 BPS. So here question is transmission delay, right? So you see transmission delay, that is L by B. Now you might be thinking like this is very easy, but there are few issues which is happening in terms of solving question. Let me tell you how things are happening. Like you see 1 KB, that is the size of packet. Now 1 KB, 1 KB is given. KB means what? 2 to the power 10 divided by bandwidth is 1000, right? 2 to the power 10, that is 1024, and divided by 1000, that will gives you 1.024 second. But some books does what, you know, like some books may consider 1 KB is 1000, and based on that you may have 1 second. But majority of times what happens, if you stay in that confusion, then majority of times you may do error when you solve problems in competitive examination. So what should be the best practice? See, best practice will be like this only. As if KB is given, consider that as per 2 to the power 10 means 1024. And as if KB is given over here also, like 1 KBPS, then 1 KB, 1 KB, that will give you 1 second over here. Then it will be fine. But as if they give in terms of 1 KB and other thing in terms of 1000, then you will have to consider this in form of 1024. Remember this, right? Now, let me explain you how propagation delay is. So, for propagation delay, it is amount of delay for frames to have transmission on the media. Like you see, here we are having connection of transmitter and receiver. And this is what medium. If I say length of this medium, that is D, then these frames will be there in terms of signals. So that signal will take time to reach at receiver. So what is that time period? That is what propagation delay. So if I say length of this medium, that is D, and if velocity of signal, that is given inside media, if it is V, then by simply high school mathematics, you can say D by V, that is time. Like you see, D is what length in terms of meter, V is what velocity in terms of meter per second. So meter, meter will get cancelled. you will be having propagation delay, that is length by velocity, length of medium divided by velocity of signal into medium, that is propagation delay. Now before I solve problem, there are few basics that you should know regarding calculation of velocity of signal inside medium. And for that, let me give you example of three cases. Like you see, for example, if you have wireless medium, so in wireless medium, velocity will be velocity of light in free space, and that will be 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, right? So for wireless medium, velocity of signal, that will be 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. There can be optical medium. So in optical medium, velocity will be there as per light signal propagating inside optical cable. So that will be as per velocity of light in free space divided by refractive index, right? So refractive index will be given to you, and refractive index, that will be greater than 1, right? And you will be observing, as per refractive index, velocity of signal of light, that will decrease inside optical cable. So C by N, that you will have to do, right? And when it comes to copper, at that time, what they do is, they gives you as per this, like you see, velocity of signal in copper cable is 70% of the signal which is there as per velocity of light in vacuum. So C into 0.7, that will be the velocity of signal inside copper medium, right? So in copper, they will give you like this. In wireless, they may not give you. In that case, directly consider this. In optical, you will have to consider that as per velocity of light divided by refractive index, right? So here, let us consider one example. Like if optical cable is 1 kilometer long, and if refractive index of cable is given 1.5, then find propagation delay. So here, see, length of the cable, that is given, right? Length of the cable, that is 1 kilometer, means 1000 meter, and refractive index of cable, that is given. So refractive index, that is 1.5. so that is what we are using it to find velocity of light in optical cable, that is velocity in free space divided by refractive index. So 3 into 10 to the power 8 divided by refractive index, that is 1.5. so you can have 2 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second speed, right? And based on velocity and distance, now we can have propagation delay, that is distance by velocity. Distance is 1000, velocity, that is 2 into 10 to the power 8. So you can say this is 500 into 10 to the power minus 8. So you can say this is 5 into 10 to the power minus 6. So you can say this is 5 microsecond, right? 10 to the power minus 6 means micro. So that is how we can solve questions. So here there are few basics only that you need to note down, and based on that, anything that you can find based on propagation delay and transmission delay. I hope it is clear to you still. If anything that you would like to share it with me, note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.